Writing in a group is so much fun. I mean, you can chat with your mates, it's social, crack jokes. You know what I mean, Manon?
Yeah, but riding solo is just as much fun.
Really?
A bit of peace and quiet and a bit of me time, you know? So if you don't mind, today, I'm gonna do this one solo.
Really, Manon?
Yep, sorry.
What, like you to...
Bye!
Like you to go?
Yep.
Now?
Well, there are a few things you need to know about riding solo. So coming up are our top tips.
So seeing as Manon's left me, well, we better crack on. Our first tip for riding solo is plan yourself a route. Be well prepared. You might be really used to going out with a group and relying on those people for planning the route for you and just following the wheels. But when you're on your own, you're on your own. You're relying on yourself. So making sure you have a well-planned route is absolutely imperative. The last thing you want to do is head out for a two-hour ride and end up having done a five-hour ride because, well, you took the wrong turn, you got lost, ended up getting freezing cold, and you're stuck in a hedge. All you're wanting to do is phone home. I mean, we've all been there. So plan yourself a route that you know is well within your reach. You know the roads, or maybe it's a route you've done with the group, so you kind of recognize the roads, you know exactly where you're going on, and you can't get lost. And then the better you get and the more solo rides you're doing, you can get a bit more adventurous with your route planning.
The amount of times I've gone out on a solo ride and forgotten to take my spares and my saddlebag, I've lost count. It's important to remember these when you're riding solo because you won't have anybody else in the group to lend you a pump when you puncture. You don't want to be stood on the side of the road in the middle of nowhere waiting for a taxi. An inner tube, pump and some tyre levers and a multi-tool will get you out of most mechanicals out on your ride.
Another really important part to riding solo is letting your loved ones know exactly where you are, just in case of an emergency. Now you can get some really clever head units, like my Wahoo here, that shows exactly your location. So your loved ones can follow you every move and even know exactly what time you'll be home for dinner. Yeah, I know, that clever. One thing I would say is though, make sure you take a mobile phone with you while riding solo. And they're not just great for taking a great selfie, but they're also good just in case of emergency to phone home or even the emergency services. Now you can also get some really clever apps on this that can ping your location or that can track you. That way, even if you don't have something like a computer or head unit that does it, your phone can do it for you. There are a whole load of gadgets out there. There's even a helmet that can track your location and detect when you crash so it can ping your location to your loved ones. I know, as clever as that. But make sure you find one that works for you. That way you can keep yourself safe and you can give yourself peace of mind, but also your loved ones. Mum knows exactly what time I'm coming home for dinner. That makes me sound like I live at home. Yeah, that's awkward.
Remember to pack snacks and hydration. Any kind of snacks will do. Bananas or an energy bar like this one, there is nothing worse than running out of energy on a ride and bonking. Why not take some money in your saddlebag? So if you need to stop, you can get something from a shop. And if it's a nice day, why not stop at a cafe? There's nothing wrong with stopping at a cafe on your own.
Riding solo means you don't have the luxury of wheels to sit on to tow you around. Yep, you've got to push your own wind. Now, I am massively guilty of this. Going out on your own, smashing it, and going out too hard. But don't, go easy. Slow and steady wins the race. Not that I've got many people to race with. But it's all about pacing. And you could do so by using a bike computer like this one here. And if you've got a heart rate monitor, or even a power meter, you can work out your zones. That way you can sit within yourself, not push it too much, which means you don't blow. Now, if you're feeling really good on your ride, you're feeling fresh, energized, and you really want to push out a good session, why not chuck in maybe some efforts, a 10 minute above threshold. Now, this will really test you, but it's a good thing to do on your own because you can't really do it in a group. There's different abilities, and this means you'll split up the group. So use this solo riding time as a way where you can push your boundaries, do the efforts, and go flat stick when you want to. No efforts for me though. Not today.
Yep. Another perk of riding solo is that you can stop as many times as you want. You don't have to worry about anybody else. If you find a pretty view, stop and take it in, and maybe even a pic for the gram. Not of yourself, Hank, of the view.
What?
Of the view, sheep.
God, Manon left me ages ago, determined to have a solo ride, and actually, kind of enjoyed it, but where on earth is she?
All right, Hank.
Oh, here you are.
How was your ride?
Actually, not as bad as I thought it was going to be. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the peace and quiet looking at the views, and I even got the chance to take a few selfies.
Oh yeah, solo rides aren't that bad after all, are they?
Really not, actually.
No.
If you guys have a few tips for us that we haven't mentioned or we missed off the list, then make sure you put them in the comment section below.
And if you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up.
Yeah, and why not let us know what you would prefer? Group riding or solo riding? What would you go for?
Solo, I think.
Solo?
I quite like it, yeah.
See, I'm a fan of group riding. Do you want me to tell you
why?
I
know you are.
No, do you want me to tell you why?
Go on.
Well, it means you can chat, you can chat jokes.
Take selfies with other people.
Selfies with other people. You can even get people laughing at your jokes, which doesn't happen.
You can half wheel.
You can half wheel.
You like a bit half wheel and don't.
See, there is loads of good positives. Let me hear your positives.
What?
Oh, he stopped. Don't hold me on it. Right. Should we ride back in a group?
Yeah, big group.
Yeah. Should we ride back in twos, or are you going to...
Single file.
Determined to ride solo again? Solo. Okay. Thanks for watching, guys. See ya!